these questions, you know, because the unfortunate thing about academia is that it's the violence in academia is that it forces you to separate, to fragment, you know, to leave the mind and the body in separate spheres. And the emotions and the spiritual are non-existent in academia because it's not considered logical. It's not Cartesian, you know, you can't really think if you're emotional. So it forces us, I think, as people of color, as women of color, as feelers, thinkers, as indigenous people that have grown up with all of those senses and all of those faculties in our identity, in our way of thinking, it really sort of disrupts us, you know, and it shakes us to the point of like, you don't exist, basically, you know, and that's why I say it's violent, because it's an erasure. So, el llanto, what las maestras have brought to us is a reminder, you know, it's a reminder, un recuerdo, un consejo to like, you don't separate, you know, you're all of it, you're all of it. And reconnect with that first llanto you gave when you came into this world. Reconnect with that joyful llanto, or that need to be cared for llanto, that help llanto, that I'm angry at you llanto, you know, that come on, let's activate llanto, you know. It's like forced us to remember that, you know, and to include it in the dialogue and in the discourse of academia. And that's our survival, you know, that's our survival. So when so in the larger kind of, like I was saying, the larger political landscape, it is very much rooted about what's happening in the now at the border with the separation of the families and the reality, like that reality and what the women are feeling, what the children are feeling, what our collective consciousness is telling us to feel, you know, as Chicanos, as conscious people. So in bringing that back into the academic discourse, we're reminding ourselves of our humanity, you know, of our original existence. We are forcing each other. We're like inviting each other to say, hey, you know, I'm here and I should be acknowledged, and don't attempt to erase me, you know. Let's put ourselves back together. So, you know, as a faculty of color, for me, it's always important to have my students like right from that place of knowing, you know, right from that, from like what Sheree was saying, like with your body, like how does it feel today, and then how is that going to come through the pencil, how's that going to come through on the page, how's that going to come through in your speech, you know, and in your story. So it's a reconnection, it's a coming back to like the original place.